Hey everybody, how's it going? Now, I've used Driver4 VR in the past, and somebody has turned me on to KinectToVr VR, which is supposed to be a free version of getting the Kinect to work. So I'm actually going to try to set it up for the first time on a whim. I haven't tested this before, just to see how it compares to Driver4 VR, which is a paid-for Kinect tracking with Steam. So first things first, just to show you here, the Kinect sensor is connected to my PC. I also have the Kinect Runtime version 2 and Kinect SDK version 2 installed on my computer. This is a fairly fresh install. I haven't done it on this computer yet, so we're gonna go ahead and just go visit the site. Free and open solution for Kinect body tracking. It is worth noting that I have the Xbox One Kinect. I got it for $39, I want to say. It's somewhere around there, 35 to 40 bucks. So let's go ahead. It says get it up and running in under 5 minutes. Let's see if that's true. Okay, system requirements, that's fine. Need room scale VR, that's fine. Need a large enough room. I usually have to stand all the way back to the wall, but that should be fine. Continue. Yeah, webcams won't work with this. This is literally just for PlayStation Move, Xbox One Kinect, and the Xbox 360 Kinect. Which I think the Xbox 360 Kinect you can get for like 25 bucks right now, actually. For this almost the same price as a decent webcam. Okay, let's download. Install. Windows protected PC. More info. Run it anyways. Did I get a virus? Oh well. Alright, begin installation. I have a... Yep, that's detected. Wow, it already detected my sensor. That's pretty cool. Okay. Now, so far everything looks good. Complete installation. Okay, so where's the program? Close this window. First time setup view instructions. Okay. Pretty straightforward. Alright, let's see. Kinect to VR, okay. Well, just search it, I guess. And the lights went on my Kinect. It's thinking. Okay, it's already opening Steam. That's kind of interesting. Couldn't initialize VR system. Okay, so my first issue was you gotta open your Steam or whatever platform you're using for your VR. You need to connect your headset and then start the Kinect to VR. Then it will pick up everything. So we are going to try to do this. Let's see, trackers, so that's options. Let's see here. So I'm gonna move this back and try to get this set up officially. I'm hoping I can just jump into vrchat and do the same test I did for Driver4 VR back in the day. Okay, having some problems here. Huh.
Weird. All right, I'm gonna have to try to fix this. Okay, so I am not getting this working. Let's try this again.
So I haven't been able to get it to work. I'm going to go to their site and look for some setup stuff. Now, the downside to this is it doesn't work immediately. Whereas Driver VR picked up everything, it was easy to calibrate, it was easy to just go in and use full body tracking. Even if it was a little off, you could modify it so it worked better immediately. Whereas this, it does seem like it's not fully compatible with everything. So we're gonna just go in here with this type of browsers. Okay, let's see here. Documentation. Calibrating trackers. Troubleshooting. Expect to enter PlayStation Move them comparing devices. Price. Conflict with Xbox One Kinect uses time. Okay, so I have an Xbox One Kinect and it's not working very well, which is a little odd. So let's see, this becomes an issue in devices, base stations. This doesn't apply to me, it literally just deleted my controllers. Okay, so KinectToVr has potential, but I don't think it's going to work for my Kinect Xbox One, whereas Driver4 VR does. So I'm obviously going to continue to use Driver4 VR for mine. One, because I already have the device. Two, Driver4 VR also has webcam support. So KinectToVr seems cool and it seems like it might work for most people, but for me it's not working. Okay, so final thoughts on the KinectToVr. It's free, so my expectations were a lot lower than Driver4 VR. It works, you can see it tracking, but it's not automatic. It doesn't implement things immediately. So from a, get set up in 5 minutes, not true on the Xbox Kinect One, on the Kinect Xbox One. Based on the documentation I'm seeing, it should work for the 360 Kinect just fine, and the PS Move, but as far as the Xbox One Kinect, it doesn't seem like it's working very well or picking things up at all, for that matter. Driver4 VR picks up webcam very well for 180 degrees. It picks up the Kinect Xbox One perfectly fine for 180 degrees. The reason I wanted to try this was it seemed like it was able to do 360 perfectly fine, which it doesn't seem to. So I'm hoping that either Microsoft or the people that created KinectToVr can implement it a little better. Real quick, I'd like to go over the price comparison of the different setups and things that you can do for cheap full body tracking. Let's say you buy an Xbox 360 Kinect for $40, the same price as an Xbox One Kinect. I'm just highballing it so you know the worst case scenario pricing. So if you're going to use a Kinect, the adapter, and the free software, KinectToVr, you're looking at about $64 for the Kinect, the adapter, and the free software. Now, if you want to go on the higher end and get an Xbox One Kinect, get the adapter, and buy Driver4 VR, you're looking at about $82. So you can get that full body tracking for $82. Now, if you want to go the absolute low end for full body tracking, you can get a $20 webcam, and then you can buy Driver4 VR. So that is going to run you about $38. Now keep in mind, this is before taxes, this is before shipping, so give or take $5 or $10 depending on where you live. So webcam and Driver4 VR, $40. Kinect, adapter, and free software, $64. And then Driver4 VR, the Kinect adapter, and an Xbox One Kinect, you are looking at $82. So those are three full body tracking methods for under $100. I myself, and what worked for me, was the Driver4 VR, the Kinect Xbox One, and the adapter. So I paid the $82 for the full body tracking. Now, a lot of these devices I already had, so this was the best option for me. If you already have a webcam, then go get Driver4 VR. If you already have a Kinect, why not try the KinectToVr software? So you got to see what best fits your circumstance for full body tracking. I hope you guys found this informative. I'm sorry I couldn't get KinectToVr working. Maybe their team can reach out to me and we can talk to see how to get that to work. So it stopped all the full body motion, but I was able to see all the trackers. Now, I could set it up manually and it could take some time, but it said it up within 5 minutes. I wanted to see if I could. I had better luck with Driver4 VR. It was very automatic. So, but yes, you can absolutely set it up manually. Until next time, have a great one.